Yo, for all my THC lovers out there, I know you need something that's gonna help you be creative, focused, and energized, right? Because look, your boy got ADHD, and a little something is gonna help me out, all right? Mood is known for their federally legal THC. Now they're adding their most potent product yet to the lineup, okay? And for a limited time, Mood is giving our listeners a free THCA pre-roll and 20% off your first order. Just visit hellomood.com and use our code DUDES, okay? Look, it's different strains for specific moods, from euphoric to energized, creative to chill. I like all that, okay? So try Mood's new THCA flower today for a limited time only. Get 20% off your first order and a free THCA pre-roll. Just go to hellomood.com and use promo code DUDES. That's hello, MOOD.com, code DUDES for 20% off your order and a free THCA pre-roll.
Dudes, behind the foods. Yo, it's the dudes, behind the foods. Dudes, behind the foods. Yeah, it's the dudes behind the foods.
That's actually really fucking good.
Life is like a hurricane. Duck bird. Something's out of danger, and it's a duck blur. The danger lurks behind you. Another stranger out to find you. And something duck tail. Woo! Hey, what's up, man?
Let me tell you something.
Why are you so tired?
So, listen, you know, when you guys are in your 20s, I was once in my 20s. I remember going out till like 5 a.m., whatever, mm-hmm. and then the next day, I'm fine.
Yeah.
And it's, maybe it's not so much that I'm fine, I just kind of fight through it. I drink a coffee, I'm fine, right? So I'm hanging out with my buddy Jason Chenny, and I get a call from the one and only Joseph Vincent.
What?
I haven't seen this dude in probably like 7 years, right? We just all got busy doing our own thing. And, you know, me and just Joseph, we just kick it all the time.
Pretty ass Joseph Vincent.
Yeah, super, still pretty as fuck, dude.
Of course.
Pretty ass wife, pretty ass couple. And so it's like 10:30, I'm already out.
At night. Okay.
But I was already having dinner with a buddy of mine, and I saw this thing come up. I'm like, Joseph Vincent, he calls me.
Okay.
Now, there's a couple of things that happens when a friend calls you. Number one, why the fuck are you calling me?
Mm-hmm.
Number two, if I get a phone call from a friend late at night, I think they're in trouble.
Yeah, immediately.
Immediately. So I see his name, I'm like, is he in trouble?
Well, I do this, dog. The fuck? Why are you calling me? Yeah. And I go, are you okay? I text, are you good?
You pick up, are you okay? No. Boop. Yeah. Text, are you okay?
Are you okay? No. Boop. What's wrong? I text, what's going on?
Why'd you do that? Nothing. You just called me as gross.
Yuck. Okay, continue.
So I think something's wrong, and I pick up. But no, he just wanted to kick in. He just hasn't been out in a long time. I think he probably assumed I was still in K-Town and stuff.
Oh, okay.
But I was already out. I was like, you know what? Fuck it. Let's just hang out. Then we hung out till like 2:30 in the morning.
Crazy.
Just catching up, talking about life. And then I got home. And then it took me 2 hours to go to sleep, so I slept around like 4:30.
It took you 2 hours to go to sleep?
Yeah.
Pero por qué?
Because I have to... What'd you call me for? I could just...
You poor gay. Why couldn't you sleep?
Because I had dick on my mind. It takes me a while to unwind. And then the next day I woke up, I was like, oh shit. I'm fucking exhausted. Like, I haven't felt this exhausted because I don't stay up that late anymore,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, same.
But then because I've been waking up at 8 a.m. or 9 a.m., I just wake up at 8. So the next day, yesterday, dog, I took a 5.5 hour nap.
What? That's sleep.
I know.
You went to sleep.
So that's why, again, I slept at 4:30. Because I slept for 5 fucking hours. And now I'm over here just fucking tired as shit, dog.
Yes, fool.
Dog, I can't believe, I only slept 3 hours.
I had such a confusing text exchange with him right now. I pulled up, I was like, yo, tell him I'm gonna be there in like 5 minutes. I thought he was gonna be here. He was here, but he was like, I have food cooking. And he's like, I have food cooking at 12:30. And I'm like, it's noon right now, is when we're supposed to start. And I'm like, this fool's in his kitchen cooking? When we're supposed to, I'm like, all right, whatever, man. So I text our, it's not Robyn Couch today. Robyn Couch is sick. We'll get better, Robyn. And I'm like, David's going to be here at 12:30. I'm just going to sit in my car and go through email. She's like, cool. I text David. I'm like, all right, I'll talk to the new girl, I guess. David's like, no, I'm here. No, at first he said 2:30. I was like, what? You're going to be cooking till 2:30? Like, what's happening?
I know.
He's like, I'm here. I'm like, what are you saying?
I'm just so exhausted. I keep fucking up. I'm not used to this shit, man. The cool thing is when you see friends over a long time and you start sharing stories, there's like stuff that you forgot about. A
lot of shit.
And then it just starts clicking. And so he was like, do you remember this time when we were playing basketball? And then it fucking clicked because this shit was so fucking funny. Mm-hmm. So back in the day, me, Joseph, Vincent, and Jason Chen, we played ball together, mm-hmm. right? And this is during a time I had a very good temperament, right? I was still a little, you know, young buck that gets angry, you know, pretty easy. And so before we go play ball, I gave Joseph Vincent this pre-workout called Jacked. If you guys remember back in the day, it was Jack 3D.
I do not remember, no.
So this thing got taken off the shelves because they found out it had like some, whatever chemical compound that was in it was very similar to meth. And so people love this shit. You took a scoop of this, you were wired.
Yeah.
When in college, when I initially lost a lot of weight, and this was like the strongest I ever was mm-hmm. in college, was because I took that shit every day.
Oh, God.
I would play 3 games of basketball and then do circuit weight training after because you just had so much energy. I was basically taking meth and I had no idea.
Sheesh.
So when I moved to LA, I had a box of my shit.
Yeah.
Guess what I had?
Oh.
I had one bottle left of the banned substance before they changed the formula.
Oh, God. You're like fucking Wolf of Wall Street with the expired Percocets.
Yes, yes.
Quaaludes. Quaaludes. Yeah.
So I found this and it was sealed. Still ready to go. So I'm like, dude, this is the original format. And eBay at the time, they were selling it for a shit ton of money.
Word.
Because everybody wanted that feeling again. Mm-hmm. So I gave some to Joseph Vincent. I didn't know he's never had this before.
Oh, God.
So this fool played basketball so hard because he was basically on meth.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Running 4 games back to back. The next day, he called me saying that he had to go to the hospital.
What?
Because he couldn't walk because he had so much shin splints.
Oh, my God. Oh, he was just so sore.
Just playing basketball, full court games back to back. I stopped. Well, I actually forgot about this part of the story where I got into a fight at the gym. I don't remember this.
Okay.
And he was like, do you remember at the gym when you got into a fight? I was like, oh, my God. So this is the stupidest thing. Mm-hmm. So you remember that? Apparently, this is a habit of mine where I say really weird things when I get angry, just like when I was like in that cab driver where I was like, you're a terrible person.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I did something very similar here.
All right.
We're playing ball. This guy, long pass, I grab the ball. I'm running it up court. Guy decides to foul me, but he dips his shoulder and he shoulder into my chest and I go flying.
Oh, no.
And I get up and I go fucking red.
Crying, oh.
And then and I start crying, right? I take off my pants, I put on my diaper and I pee in it. I flip out, I start getting mad and I just start fucking socking the wall because I'm so enraged.
Oh, he's socking walls,
and I
man.
Run up to this guy to fight this fool.
Okay.
I run up to him and he goes, dude, I'm so sorry. And I just go, I go like this. And I hug him. I'm like, it's okay, man. And then I walked away. And I remember Joseph, Vincent, and Jason was like, what the fuck was that? I was like, he said sorry. I can't hit him after that. He said sorry. So I stand up like getting him. I go, it's okay, brother. And I just
That's adorable. We should get you some meth.
I know.
I think we should get you some meth to calm you down, dog.
I was thoroughly surprised how it went from motherfucker, hey, it's all good, bro. And I just hugged him and I just walked off and we just continued the game. And they're like, what was that? And like, I felt so bad if I socked the dude that
said, apologize. Yeah,
he said sorry.
I get it.
And that's really
it.
All you want.
I did not know you and Joseph Vincent were homies like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I did not know that. You know, for those of y'all who aren't familiar, you know, with the Asian YouTube singer days, the golden age of the YouTube Asian era, Joseph Vincent, very attractive man.
Sweet guy.
I can sing, play guitar.
Butter smooth.
Very like, you know, calm, cool voice. Almost like a Asian John Mayer vibes, I would say.
You know what's really cool about Joseph Vincent? I don't know if everybody talked about this. Like, he's still very handsome, everything else like that. He's married. But he had a girlfriend during the heydays of YouTube, right? Mm-hmm. In a very long-term relationship. You want to talk about a man who's faithful.
Mm-hmm.
This dude, I would see like girls basically throw labia at him, dude.
Yes, they would rip their labia off and literally, and like, yeah. Or they would fling them at him like rubber bands. They would just put it around their ring finger and bing!
I saw a girl take off her pants and she pulled her labia back and she put a diamond ring on it and just got right on the stage. It's fucking stupid.
This girl, this one girl, dog, baked her whole bottom half into a cookie and had the restaurant bring it out to him like it was a complimentary dessert. So he would accidentally eat her cooch.
Yes.
It was crazy.
Wow, this cookie's really big.
But yes, very attractive man, and could have had plentiful groupies back in the day. But you know, he's been a one woman man from the jump.
Yeah, man, and like the way he would like conduct himself around like these women, they would just, you know, very respectful. Just yeah. Like, damn, like he wouldn't even like flirt.
It's yeah, like, I don't remember him
I'm like,
ever.
Damn, dog.
Yeah,
like look, I know for a lot of people, like of course, but you know. When you're young and in your 20s, like he was a young 20s, you don't see that type of loyalty. You know?
Yeah, that's facts, bro. Actually, you know, thank God I was single during that time.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Because we rolled, you know, when we moved, we were some dirt bags. You feel me? Yeah. Like Joseph Vincent, though, and I've had a couple shows with Joseph Vincent. We actually even had a show just me and him. Out of college. It was dope. I do a thing with Andrew whenever I perform with Andrew where we bring a girl on stage and we like improvise a song about her. And me and Joseph did that. It was a good time. But I also have a funny story of feeding Joseph Vincent some type of food and it went wrong.
Oh, no.
It was a show in, I do believe it was Las Vegas or something. It was an event. It wasn't a show. It was a showcase for like Google or some big company, right? But they had a bunch of like, it was me, Erica David, Joseph Vincent, some, I do believe, I forget who exactly was there. But bunch of Asian singers and rappers. But it was a sponsored event. So it was like full spread, seafood fucking buffet, ooh. Lobster, oyster, crab legs, all that shit, right? All you can eat. So Joseph's like, you know, I've never actually had raw oysters before.
Oh, no.
And I'm like, oh, dog, that's my shit. You should try it out, right? So we still were waiting to perform. It's full. He's like, all right. So I dress him up a little oyster, lemon, some, you know, cocktail sauce, whatever, whatever, a little Tabasco. He slurps it down. He's like, oh, not bad. A couple minutes later, he's like, he's getting a little red. I was like, oh, shit.
He has an allergy?
I was like, are you allergic? He's like, I don't know. I've never had one before. And he had to sing in like 10 minutes. So
he has a shellfish allergy.
I don't know if he still does. Let's actually text him right now and find out. But he was like, he was fine. He was fine. Thank God.
And he listens to this podcast too.
Does he?
Yeah.
He was still able to sing. But
Joseph, I'm so sorry that this bastard did that to you. He looked like fucking Will Smith and Hitch.
Yeah. Hey, man, quick question. So me and David are doing the podcast. We literally have been speaking about you for the past 12 minutes. And remember that time we had that show where I had you try raw oysters and you had like a low-key reaction? Was that like a one-off situation or are you still allergic to oysters or shellfish in general? Let me know, man. Hey, how are you, Doc? Okay.
This little poison, right before he's about to sing, he comes out just...
All a part of my plan.
So he can't get any of the women. When I first met Joseph, it was at the San Diego Asian Film Festival. This is actually when I met Bart and Joe, just kidding, everybody else, Blogilates, all these people. And I went out there and then I see this guy in front of me, just sexy as fuck. And I look at him and he goes, hey, what's up, man? I'm Joseph. I was like, hey, man, I need you to go to the back of the line. He's like, why? I was like, because I can't stand next to you. I'm 10 times uglier by comparison. You need to go stand somewhere else. Like, this is not fair. So I just moved next to Bart and Joe. But yeah, we became friends right after that. He's such a sweet dude.
Yeah, good
really
dude,
good
man.
Sense of humor too.
Good dude. Good dude. Oh man, I haven't seen him in a very, very, very long time, bro. So
we were out till like 2:30. I haven't been out that long in ages, man.
You know, I kind of, my body, if I have work to do, I forget what it was the last time, but I was up very, very, very late and I had to be up filming something at like, I had to get up at like 5 a.m. I forgot what the fuck it was, but I remember just like immediately, maybe I was even filming with you, I forget, but 5 a.m. I was up. I was, all right, let's get it. I was good.
It
was
with me. And then the next day you had to do another shoot and you were just there. I was out.
Yes.
You're fucking nuts. I can't do that. You're just like, okay, I'm good. Not me. When I took that nap, I woke up 2 hours later in between the nap before the 5.5. And it felt like there was a magnet pulling me into the couch and I couldn't get up. So I was like, fuck it. Let me just close my eyes for 10 more minutes. And it was 3.5 more hours. I fucking, dog, it was bad.
I actually did get, I was a little hungover the other day because, you know what, dog? I think I really need to stick with, like, you know, because I be on the Repo tequila. Like, Reposado is my shit, right? The yellowy one, you know what I'm saying? And I was kind of thinking, oh, if I drink, like, quality clear tequila, I'll be all right. But I was having some pretty quality, like, you know, top shelf tequila. And the clear, though, was, like, probably some Añejo or some shit, or some Blanco. And it was, I still, next day, dog, I fucking had a headache. And I never have a headache off the Reposado, you know? So I don't know, man. I think I just can't fuck with clears,
you
man.
You know what it is, dog? Mm. It's because you're over here fucking working out, getting fit. Ew, look at me. I'm fit now. Ew, I just want it all.
I'm not even fit yet, dog.
I hate it so much because it makes me feel so bad about myself. Because I'm over here just smoking weed and eating chips, watching you work out. I'm like, what the fuck is this, huh?
Well, you said this is six-pack year for you. You've been going hard as shit.
So check this out, right? Now, I'm still consistent with it. You know, I'm playing the slow game now.
Saying I'm playing the slow game for working out is so funny. It's the long con, baby.
Yeah.
You think I'm gonna stay fat forever? All a part of my plan.
Don't say it like that.
We're gonna take a break and you're gonna tell me what the fuck you're talking about right after this.
Dudes Behind the Foods listeners, this podcast is brought to you by Mood, my friends. Well, Mood's latest and most potent breakthrough in the world of legal cannabis. Since THCA converts it to THC when you heat it, you get access to the classic marijuana high, and Mood has 10 high-inducing strains, the most potent they've ever offered. These are THC products you can trust, my friends. And remember, they are regularly tested in third-party labs. Listen, when I garden on the Sundays, baby, you already know I'm using some of Mood's products. Here's what I love. Specifically, I like their pre-rolls because they tell you the mood that they put you into, whether it's productive, whether it's focused, whether it's sleepy. And yes, my friends, it's not BS because I tried all of them and they do exactly what they say they do. I like the one that's like a social one where it kind of gets you there, but you're still cognizant and you're relaxed. So I could farm my days away. Mood, baby. I freaking love them. Great for both beginners and veteran users. So try Mood's new THCA flower today for a limited time only. Get 20% off your first order and a free THCA pre-roll. Just go to hellomood.com and use promo code DUDES. That's hello, MOOD.com. Code DUDES for 20% off your order and a free THCA pre-roll.
Joseph Vincent replied. He says, ha, 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 no, I love oysters now, and I'm not allergic, was just dumb and didn't know what was good. Hope you and the family are good, brother. Well, okay, man, well, great to hear that, bro. great to hear that. I hope you're good as well, everything.
Send nudes.
David says, send nudes. And same to you and wifey, bro. Hope all is well. All right, man. Take care. Peace.
So I got this long game, right?
Long game. Long fit game.
I'm playing the long fit game right now, right? It's been going for about 30 years. So I've been playing it real well. It's been happening. And then, like, so I've been dabbling in the weed when I do gardening and stuff. Here's the thing that I realized is, like, I'm going to go back to only smoking when I need it for going to sleep and stuff, because I didn't realize how much weed makes you eat.
Mm.
Right? That munchy stuff is some real shit.
For sure.
So here's the thing. When people said that weed makes food taste better, I don't think that's true. It doesn't make it taste better. You don't register when you're full.
Mm.
But it makes you like want to eat. It doesn't make, I actually taste the food less. I can't taste everything. I just know that, oh, this feels good. And then you're so high, you kind of get into this trance of constantly eating.
Hmm.
But it doesn't make the food taste better.
Well, I don't smoke enough to know about that. But I don't know, man. Well, you know, they say that, I mean, there's so many different strands that do so many different things, dog. Who knows? Maybe there's a strand that heightens your senses, dog.
Maybe. But all I know is that it just makes you constantly eat because you get into this weird trance. Mm. And it doesn't necessarily make it taste better, but the feeling of eating is like really good. So like I ate so much. And so this past Sunday, fucking Porto's.
Mm.
Pizza Hut pizza. Fucking Ooh. Dog. Hey.
I agree. Whatever you're about to say, I agree.
So we got it. And it was like warm.
Yeah.
But it wasn't hot enough, so we put it back in the oven.
Yeah.
And that bottom like greasy crust mm-hmm. layer, it's so fucking good.
Look, man, people give Pizza Hut a bad rap. You know what I'm saying? But I fuck with Pizza Hut, dog. The long way, okay? And that's not just the nostalgia talking, because me and my family used to go to Pizza Hut. Like, that was our little treat. You know what I'm saying? Sit down restaurant Pizza Hut with the fucking Whoa. Salad bar. Breadsticks with the warm marinara sauce, bro. That was our shit, dog. And I still will fuck up some Pizza Hut to this day. And some cold fucking Pizza Hut the next day, homie.
I don't know about the cold stuff. But the bottom crust of the dough that they have, they fry it in like a butter or margarine or oil.
Yeah.
If you guys ever been to a restaurant called Mother Wolf, right? One of my favorite Roman Italian style restaurants okay. is in LA, also out in Vegas. They're known for this focaccia bread.
Mm-hmm.
The bottom part of the Pizza Hut tastes like Mother Wolf's focaccia bread.
Okay, okay.
It's fucking delicious. And we're talking about Mother Wolf is like a highfalutin restaurant, very mm-hmm. well-known chef, delicious. It tastes like that focaccia bread.
All right.
It's next level shit. All the other fast food restaurants have their pizza, but Pizza Hut is especial. It's like chicken McNugget special.
Ooh, like that?
Yes.
Wow.
I ate four slices.
Jeez.
I had Portos. I had all this other shit, and it was because of the wheat. And I ate a whole family-sized bag of Dorito chips.
Family size?
Yes, I'm not even lying.
Sheesh. Of Doritos? What flavor?
The regular nacho ones.
Fire. And also, let me ask you this. What was on your pizza?
It was the Meat Lovers. Sausage, pepperoni.
And do you dip your pizza into anything?
The Pizza Hut ranch.
Fire as well?
Crazy.
So good.
When I went home, I weighed myself.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, I wonder how much I ate, because I took off my shirt and my stomach was like bulbous.
Mm-hmm. And you said, what else is new?
I know. It doesn't look like that normally. Do you understand me, you piece of shit? I took, okay, well, now I'm never going to take my shirt off in front of you because I'm very self-conscious. And all this food's for me now.
No, so I'm hungry. We
looked at my stuff and it was like just completely round. And so I was like, I don't even feel full. How? I get on the scale. I'm normally 215 pounds
because
I lost 3 pounds. I was 223 pounds.
What?
8 pounds of food.
What period of time?
3 hours.
No.
I'm not even kidding you. No. It was 3 hours.
That can't be right.
You know why?
Why?
Because I got into my ADHD mode and I was farming that day.
Okay.
I had my first meal at 8. I got home at 11. So we started eating at 8. In 3 hours, I gained like 8 or 9 pounds of food.
Well, did you shit it out the next day at least?
Well, so the next day, I shat it out, pissed it out, did everything.
Yeah.
But I wasn't full. So I'm like, I can't smoke weed like that anymore. Because it's fucking up with my fitness goals, dude.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How do you eat 8 to 9 pounds of food and not feel full? What the fuck is weed? Weed is crazy, dude.
That is pretty crazy. I'm glad I don't smoke because I love food way too much. You know what I'm saying?
You would look like me. But short.
Terrible.
You look like George Costanza, dude.
You, with your hair right now, you kind of look like that little Japanese yapper Asian boy on Instagram.
What is hate? Hate is something you feel inside that's not tangible. What's tangible? It's something you can touch.
Chemical imbalance coming from the... Hey, you know what? What did you bring us today? Because I brought us special beverages.
So, Blue Jam Cafe.
Oh, you guys, Blue Jam!
Oh, Blue Jam!
I love some Blue Jam. I want to put the Blue Jam.
Bayan, before the whole foodie hype thing started happening, Blue Jam Cafe was a breakfast spot that was doing next level breakfast shit before other people were doing it.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. There may be some other restaurant, but Blue Jam really kind of, I saw a lot of people copy what Blue Jam was doing. Mm. And they're still fucking fire.
And if you don't know what that is, Google Blue Waffle. And you will see something fun. Have you ever Googled Blue Waffle?
No.
Do that right now before we start eating.
Nope, because I'm gonna throw up and I already know. I already know you, and I almost did it right now, and then my senses came back, and I just so was like, oh, that's right, Drake's dick. Okay, we'll your dick with Drake on top of
we'll
it.
We'll do it after we eat. We'll do it after
you
we eat.
You fucking disgusting bastard. You almost got me. I was this close. And then I remembered who you are, you stupid piece of shit. So I saw some interesting stuff on their menu that I haven't seen. Breakfast pasta.
Oh, fire.
Never.
Let me tell you this, bro. I always will take leftover spaghetti, leftover pasta. I put it in a frying pan the next day, a little bit of oil. I crack an egg into it, and I scramble eggs into the pasta, and I call it my breakfast pasta.
Well, there you go. And then we got breakfast crepes with hash.
Oh, let me tell you, bro. I'll take my crepes left over the next day. I take a little hash in there, a little egg. I call it my breakfast crepes.
And they're very famous, crunchy, deep-fried French toast.
Oh, let me tell you, dude.
Shut the fuck up. Hey, let me tell you that, dude, that's so crazy because you know what I do, man? I take my French toast, right? I get some eggs and I French toast egg it. You're so fucking dumb, dog.
Oh my God.
You're a piece of shit.
I am dead. I'm actually dead, guys.
I fucking love it, dude.
Oh, shit.
Which one do you want to eat first and then we'll switch off?
I want to try the pasta first.
Okay, I'll do the crepe.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fucking hilarious.
Wow. And here's what I brought. Since you told me that we were going to be having breakfast, I wanted to drink alcohol. And I was going to get Bloody Marys at first, but I was like, I don't want no canned Bloody Mary shit. Because if I'm having Bloody Mary, I want it with the celery. I want it with all that shit, right?
Bacon.
Yeah. So I got some Micheladas.
Hey. The Mexican Bloody Mary. Bloody Maria.
Bang, bang. Budweiser. Chilada with clamato, dog.
Oh.
Yeah, not just tomato juice. So with clamato, I feel like this is more of a, so have you ever had a Caesar from Canada? Of course not.
No. That's how Mexican people say scissors.
Me and my homegirl, we like to Caesar on the weekend. But if you ever had a Caesar in Canada, it's a Bloody Mary, but they use clamato instead of tomato juice.
Oh.
And it's way better. It's like a little sweeter. Mm-hmm. It's just tastier. And for whatever reason, they don't make Caesars out here. Like, no one at the bar has fucking clamato on deck like that. But yeah, here we go.
Picante.
Yes, sir.
Spicy.
Cheers to you, my guy.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. This is fucking good.
Yes, yes, yes.
That's fucking delicious.
Mmm.
That's good.
Yes, sir. That's great.
Was Budweiser the one that got canceled for trying to be woke?
I forget.
What was that Coors?
I forget. I don't even know if it was like necessary trying to be woke. Like they had like a, I think it was like a trans person in a commercial and people got mad.
I don't fucking know.
All right. Y'all should, first of all, get a look at this breakfast pasta because it looks great. It's macaroni noodles. Looks like some bacon and some scrambled eggs and some cheese. I'm not eating cheese right now, but because I'm on this like fitness journey, but
this guy suddenly gets a personal trainer.
Mm.
This is very good, but honestly, it just reminds me of what I make at home where I just get a tortilla, ham and cheese.
Well, this is really good, but
it tastes like what you thought it was gonna taste like.
It tastes what I thought it was gonna taste like. It's pasta with scrambled eggs and cheese, which is fucking great.
Mm-hmm.
Like, would I order this at the restaurant? Yes, because it's really good. Their bacon that they use is bomb too. I actually like that. Sometimes I'm in a crispy bacon mood. Sometimes I'm in a squishy bacon mood. This is not crispy. They went with the squish, and I am enjoying it.
Oh, I love this drink.
That's great. Mm-hmm. Here, trade juice. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Listen, guys, I know that sometimes I be chewing into the mic because I get really into it. I apologize. But we do it for ASMR purposes.
This fool David replied to one of my workout stories, and he was like, oh, you really working out.
Bro, you know, like, some people say they're working out, it's like light shit. I'm like, that shit looks tiring as fuck.
I know.
You're working out, dog.
So tiring, bro. Like, you know.
This guy's trainer has him to pad work with, like, 14,000 hit combos. I'm like, dog, that looks exhausting as fuck.
The combos are more exhausting mentally than physically, to be honest. Because, like, you know, I don't have any experience with, like, choreography. You feel me? My brain doesn't really work like that. So for me to really remember the longer combos, I really kind of have to, like, lock in. You know what I'm saying? And almost let my brain, like, shut my brain off. And like, just
don't,
like,
overthink it.
Yeah. Because then if I'm concentrating too much on the numbers and the combos and I'm like, my form is all fucked up. And here's what's funny, too, about when you start posting little boxing shits, because I almost didn't want to do it, you post at all. But then I'm like, yeah, I kind of like posting it, showing a little bit of progress, but whatever. But here's the thing, and I always make sure to preface this shit with, like, I'm not trying to be a professional boxer, y'all. I'm not trying to do no YouTube.
The workout.
Yes, I'm just trying to get some fun cardio in, you know what I'm saying? But there's always somebody in the comments, like, and look, I appreciate a couple comments here and there, like, give me a couple pointers, yeah, like, okay, cool, tell me to keep my hands up. There's someone was like, hey, man, you know, form's looking good, Tim, just keep your hands up. I'm like, great. But there's, like, somebody who was like, man, the form is not it, my guy, you know? I was like, man, I just want to do some cardio, I don't care.
Even if that, right, you literally just started.
And it's there's,
like,
that, yeah.
There's, like, these people, too, where it's just, do you chime in to correct what other people do because you can't do it yourself? Like, you don't have to comment on that. Is he a professional fighter? Is he going to use these out in the streets? Is he even trying to box for real? Who the fuck cares? It's a fucking workout. And I know you want to say, well, if you're going to do, you might as well just do it right. Most of you can't fucking do it right. All right?
And look,
Shut the fuck up.
I appreciate, if that's how you feel.
No! Don't talk to my friend that way.
It's all in the delivery, you know what I'm saying? Because there's definitely a difference between the one who's like, hey, man, you know, hey, looking good. Just do a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Because I get it. Like, when I watch people golf and they're doing it for the first time, you know, of course, something in me, because I took lessons for so many years, it wants to be like, oh, you know what? Just keep that foot down. Keep that left foot down. Transfer your weight. You know, it'll be way better. Keep your head down and you won't, like, you know, you won't chop into the ball as much, right? But then there's the motherfuckers like, it's not it, my guy. It's not it. It's like, yo, like, shut the fuck. I don't care.
Let me tell you something. Only one time did I ever respond back to a commenter who was talking about my videos.
Yeah.
Because I'm working with my coach, and I just started boxing at this point. I was kickboxing for about a year and a half, 2 years, and then I went to boxing just to get my hands a little nicer. And so.
The French toast.
Oh, I know. This is the banger over here. So this guy, he was, like, from Long Beach. He starts talking all this shit. And the thing is, like, I don't like fighting. I actually hate it. I fucking hate it. So, guy's talking all this shit. And then the thing that pissed me off was that he was talking shit to my coach. My coach is a former professional fighter. He's dope. Still whoops on young kids' ass. He's, like, in his 40s, right? Savant Young out of Fight Academy, Pasadena. If you guys want to get your hands right, go to fucking Savant. So, we're doing work. And if he was talking shit to me, it's fine. And he starts talking shit about Savant. And I'm like, you know, this guy, Savant would kill you. He would literally kill you. He's a coach, but he's also about that luck. Look up Savant Young versus Matt Guymon, G-U-Y-M-O-N. You'll understand what the fuck I'm talking about. So I'm a little irritated. I was like, and I just wrote, I was like, if you want to teach me a lesson, come into the gym. Right? Then he just like, I will. It's like, I was like, oh, cool. So my coach chimes in. He goes, you can come in. We'll sign papers, and then we'll just go. And I was ready. I was like, let's fucking do it.
Papers so they don't fucking sue you.
Yeah, so you have to. So yeah. I was like, okay. And then I was like, hey, can we? And the coach was like, yeah, we can get it in. We'll show him what's up. I was like, cool, come on in. Starts talking all this shit. Then he goes, you're lucky I got this disease where I can't fight anymore. Oh, my God.
Oh, yes, you told me.
Oh, my God, bro. All this other shit. And then he started threatening me with, like, oh, I'm in a gang. And I'm like, okay, you're a crazy person, dude. You're fucking nuts.
Bro, Rick used to get so, like, Rick used to really, if someone was being annoying in comments and shit, Rick used to not give a fuck. Rick would literally, like, he used to be on Snapchat with people like, here's my pin.
Oh, no.
Here's my pin. Let's go. Like, what's good?
Rick would fuck somebody up.
Too. Rick would fuck somebody. Rick's hands. You think I have heavy hands? Oh, yes. Like, I'm a naturally heavy-handed, like, just my bones are dense. But Rick is fucking heavy. Like,
he's fast, too.
He's strong. He's fast. Like, he would beat people. And people always, you know, people that didn't watch the videos would think that Rick was, like, my security guard and shit. Mm-hmm. And, like, I know, bitch, because I don't need no fucking security. Wait, But Rick would handle that for me, you know what I'm saying? And, funny shit, dog. Let me tell you this story. Let me tell you this fucking story, dog. One time we were in Vegas, okay? Let's talk about fake fans for a second, all right? I was in Vegas with Rick. I do believe we were leaving. It was either EDC or a concert. I forget what it was. It was probably EDC because it was a situation where it was difficult to find a ride back to the Strip, okay? And there were these... a guy who was, like, in charge of, like, some tram, like, a little shuttle. Had a funny accent. Not sure exactly what it was. Asian dude, though. He's like, oh, Tim, I'm a big fan. You know, I've been watching since day one, right? He's like, I can give you a ride. I'm like, cool. All right, cool, man. I'm cool. He's like, oh, you know, I'm such a fan. He said he was a fucking day watching from the beginning, right?
Wow.
I'm like, cool, yeah, give us a ride. And then he looks at Rick, and he goes, and who's this guy?
What the hell?
And I'm like, I thought you were
day one.
Yeah, like he's been a part of my channel for the longest time. He's like, oh, like camera guy or behind the scenes.
Why do people lie?
Dog, why do people lie?
You don't have to say that. You guys have been like, hey man, I saw some of your videos. I think you're funny. What's wrong with that?
Like, no one forced you to claim you were a day one, dog.
I know. I'm day one fan, man. Hey, Tim Shamalongsu's, man.
I'm your number one, man. Number one.
Nobody knows me better than you, man. I love your parents' Chinese restaurant. It's great. What the fuck? Rick's like, the hell?
Yeah, I love your R&B singing, man. It's so good. So good. Yeah, it was so annoying.
That album, Red Roses. Yeah. It's the best.
Yeah.
No, let me tell you something, man. Fan interactions are like 99% great, but there's always that 1% that's just whatever. And like, there's always like the weirdest things. Like, I'll tell you this though, man. There's a fan that always comes to all my meet and greets. I fucking love this girl. She always writes me a letter too. I read them.
Oh, that's cute.
She's just like the sweetest. She always puts me in a really fucking good mood. Mm-hmm. And every time she comes and she smiles, I give her the biggest fucking hug, man. Like, she's been supporting me for a very long time. Mm. And it's kind of trippy, too, where I always tell people, like, if you ever get to a point where you have, like, a good fan base and you start, like, changing people's lives, that's, like, where it really feels good. You know what I mean? Where it's like, damn, because of you, I've learned all this stuff. Because of you, I've done this. Mm-hmm. Like, you've helped me do all these other things. And you never think that you're really kind of affecting their lives that way. Right? And it trips me the fuck out.
Bro, let's talk about some day ones. I'm going to shout out some of my, like, hardcore fans right now. There's two specifically that come to mind. One is a lovely, lovely woman by the name of C Flakes. She's a super fan, okay? Been supporter for so long. Would always get me the most, like, thoughtful gifts at meet and greets and shit, bro. Like, brought me Anchorman on DVD because she knows I love Anchorman.
Wow.
When I was dating Chia, she brought me this present, man. It was so thoughtful. It was like, I think it was like Thai money and Eritrean money in an envelope. And it was like, you know, it was very like, you know, symbolic of me and Chia coming together, shit like that. And she's just been very dope. And, she, I think is originally, I forget where she moved from, but then, she loves dance and shit and choreography, came to LA. She's been like a very hardcore fan, has always been supportive. And then there's a girl named Rina De La Ghetto, who this is still her social media name to this day. She fucking supports, watches everything. And one time she tunes into all my live shows every time I'm streaming. And I told her ass, I was like, yo, we're going to bring you to LA because like, she's in somewhere in the DMV area, I feel. Like, either, like, I don't know, somewhere over there on the East Coast. But she's like, I can't find... She's like, she's never had either, like, ramen or pho or sushi, some Asian shit. I'm like, We're going to fly your ass out here because you're such a super fan, and I'm going to put you on to some good food, right? We haven't done it yet. It's been years. I keep telling her ass. I'm like, I'm going to bring you to L.A. I'm bringing you to L.A. I'm bringing you to L.A., and I always forget. But, like, she's like, okay, I'm waiting. I'm waiting because I'm, like, holding out on trying sushi, but I'm waiting for you.
It's been five years, Tim.
I'm like, I'll fly you out when I finish the script, right? Yeah.
She's never going to get it. She's like, I haven't had sushi. I'm 86 years old. Wow.
I ever tell you about the 86-year-old man who was a vegetarian? I saw this story about this man, literally 80-something years old. He had been a vegetarian his whole life, all right? And he said he'd only had meat like one time. He was in a hotel. He said like the bacon or sausage smelled so good, he had to get a taste, right? But other than that, he stayed vegetarian his whole life, and now he's like 80-something. And he's like, now I'm 80-something, and I want nothing more than just to eat a piece of steak. And he's like, but I can't because my teeth are so fucked up. He didn't, not his words, but paraphrasing. Yeah. And he's like, what a waste of time. I should have just eaten meat.
Wow. Yes. That is so sad.
Yeah. He's like, now I'm fucking, I want to eat a steak and I can't.
Dude, never. There's ways. You could figure it out.
Something, dog.
80 something years old, we'll get you some dentures. We'll figure it out. And then after that, chew some fucking steak.
Well,
baby.
He's dead now. We'll be right back. That's the thing, you know? That's the thing, man. It's like...
You're terrible.
I mean, he's probably dead. But you think about shit like that, and you kind of think like, you know, yeah, you want to live a long, healthy life. You know, you want to make good decisions. But then you also think, life is so unpredictable. Life is short. How much of my life do I want to spend being paranoid about shit, and how much of it do I actually want to take risks and enjoy? And
man, I talked about this recently where I was saying like, during the solo podcast, I kind of alluded to it. I want to do a whole podcast on it, but there's like certain people who I meet, well, they kind of like look at us like we have everything figured out. It's like, what the fuck are you talking about? It's just chaos, dude. You know, we just kind of trust the process and we trust in ourselves, you know? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And like, I think a lot of people have this issue where they always think about wanting to do something and they just never fucking do it,
mm-hmm.
Right? And so we call that like the rumination process. It's like, okay, if I do this, I have to do this. Just mm-hmm. fucking do it.
I know.
And then figure it out as you go, mm-hmm. right? You're going to fuck up either way, but you might as well just, like, they just never start. Mm-hmm. And then they're 60 years old and they go, okay, I'm still going to do this. It's like, dog, you could have just started and just fucked up. Because you don't even know if you're going to like it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So just try, you know?
I hear you, man. I'm going to finish the script, okay?
Like, I know this guy, right? It's a really good friend of mine. He just talks about this script. Every day, he's like, I'm going to do it. And I look at his thing, and now he's punching things. And I'm like, you don't want to do the script so bad. You got a personal trainer to work out.
No, I do. I have the trainer specifically because I feel like I'm now entering, like, phase four. You feel me? Let's say phase five, because phase four people weren't too much of a fan of, as if we're talking MCU, okay? But I'm entering another phase where I feel like I wouldn't even consider myself a YouTuber anymore. You know what I'm saying? All we're doing at this point is podcasting, right?
We're podcasters now.
So it's like, I feel like I'm at a point where I'm ready to actually evolve. You know what I'm saying? So, which is a big reason why I'm like, let me stop bullshitting, hire this trainer. Get physically right. Because now at the age we're at and with these fucking kids, if I actually want to, like, be healthy, I have to put so much effort into it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, let me hire a trainer. Let me actually get consistent so I can be, let me go to fucking get my skin lasered like I did earlier this year. So I can be camera ready for when I enter this phase of like me writing these scripts, getting this movie done, getting and then potentially doing more movies and shit. You know, yeah. I'm like, let me actually commit and get the ball rolling. You know what I'm saying?
Wow, dude, you just inspired a bunch of people out there, man. Somebody put inspirational music behind that. That shit was amazing, man.
Because it's true, you know? Because you, like you said, bro, a lot of people get caught up in the, I want to do this, but then what if this, that, and even me, even in like writing this script, it's like my neighbor who also writes for different shows and shit, you know, she told me like months ago, she's like, dude, this is your rough draft? I'm like, yeah. She's like, for a comedy? I was like, yeah. She's like, you should get that done in like 30 days. She's like, 30 days, you should have your, she's like, this is your puke draft? I'm like, yeah. She's like, just get it, just write. And she asked me like every couple, she's like, how's that script? I'm like, it's coming.
She hates you, dude.
She don't give a fuck. She's making money. But I'll sit down. I'm like, this is where it fucks me up too. I'll be like trying to write the script. I'm like, am I formatting this right? Is this how scripts are supposed to be written? And I'll go to fucking screenplay websites and shit. I'm like, am I writing this right? And I'm like, that's so silly.
Like, just write it.
I should just be writing. You know what I'm saying?
I feel most people don't get the format. That's where you hire the other writer to help you out. Like, yeah. To structure it.
I think that's what I really need to just, I just need to focus on just writing and then not being so focused on like the formatting. And
that's what we did with Gook. We just wrote and then we had Chris Din. Mm-hmm. If you guys know Wong Fu, he was a writer for Wong Fu. Mm. He's done a lot of great films. He formatted and restructured everything to make it make sense.
I see.
And so like that's what Chris is really good at.
Mm.
So you just blurp it out and then you have somebody come in and fix your shit.
You just made me realize there are probably people I could pay to structure this shit, huh?
100%.
Wow.
Yeah, so you just do your thing, they read it over and they could help restructure it. And then that's really about it. Either pay them or they want credit or something like that. That's fine. You know?
Facts.
So it's just, you know, you can do your thing, man. Just do it, dog.
Yeah.
I'm so sick of it.
I know. I'm sick of even talking about it, dog.
I'm so sick of it, dude. That's why I'm over here eating.
Well, look. Luckily for you, I'm writing your character as a fatty little sweaty fatty McGee, so this is perfect.
I'm going to get buff just to spite you. I don't even care. You have to be fat. No, I'm going to be fit.
No, keep the long con. Nah, but man, you know, I'm gonna stop talking about it. We just gonna execute, all right? This is a year of execution, okay? No more fucking talking, dog. All right?
You know what?
Yeah.
I don't believe you.
Oh, man. Look. I'm done talking about it. I'm just gonna fucking slap you across the face with a 90 to 100 page script eventually, okay?
I'm going to love it, dude.
Yeah.
I almost want this movie to get picked up so we could shoot it, get paid for it, but I want it to be like one of those movies that are so bad that is so good.
Oh, check. Mira. Even if it doesn't get picked up, right? Because, of course, I could give it to my agents at CAA, whatever. I don't know what the process is after I write this shit, but I definitely will give it to my agent. Hey, I wrote a fucking movie. Read the script. If you enjoy it, try to do something with it. If it doesn't get picked up, I can fucking do this shit out of my own pocket, or we'll fucking crowdsource or whatever, get a little bit of money, put the motherfucker on Tubi. You know what I'm saying?
Listen. I would love to have a Tubi film.
I would love to have a Tubi film.
Tubi clips on YouTube Shorts is one of my favorite things to watch, man. It is so funny how they have somehow found the worst actors that have ever existed on planet Earth. It's kind of hilarious.
Yeah.
What would I say, bitch? Let me smell that dick.
And then shoot the baby. It's always something like that.
I smell somebody's pussy on your dick. It's like, who the fuck wrote this?
Well, I want a good one. Before I do a Tubi movie, I want a good one. I want a good one, Doc.
If it's going to be on Tubi, you know it can't be good. It's not allowed to be.
You know what? Tubi's making strides, bro. Tubi's making strides. But I do want to get a movie on Tubi before they get super, like, you know, in their bag and, like, they're too good for it. You know what I'm saying?
I want to be starring in a Tubi film that everybody just goes on res that Dave is a terrible actor. He fucking sucks. And I would love it.
I'll tell you what. I got, like, a good three movies you could watch. Well, you know, I got, like, three shitty movies that you could currently watch. My acting is good. Just the movies aren't good. My at this point, for the movies I've been in, my proudest moment is when people are like, well, you are great.
You are fantastic.
I've been in a scary movie that's not scary, a comedy that's not funny. and, you know, I just, I'm, you know, working on it, bro. You know what I'm saying? Working my way up.
You're getting there, dude. You're going to get an Oscar. Watch.
That's the plan.
Hey, guess who got an Oscar?
My little funny mouth boo.
Yeah.
Emma Stone.
Two times, dude.
Dude, she's killing it. I really wanted her to win that shit, too. I was hyped for it because I really enjoyed the movie.
I see her doing these teeny, starting with these teeny bopper films, mm-hmm. these comedies.
Mm-hmm.
Then she's doing, what's it called? The theatrical one with
La La Land.
La La Land.
Fire.
Then she's doing this one, what's it called?
Poor Things.
Poor Things. It's like bomb. The range on this fucking woman, dude.
And I love seeing that, dog. I love to see somebody go from fucking super bad, which is also a classic, to go from like, you know, being in her acting bag, musical bag, winning an Oscar. Like, that's so lit to me. I love it so much because, you know, okay, another one of my like people that I look up to in at this juncture of my career, because, you know, coming up, it was like Jamie Foxx, Will Smith. I was like, I fuck with people that could do it all. Music, acting, comedy, right? But now that I'm actually trying to write a movie, and I've talked to you about this before, I'm really trying to be in my Jordan Peele bag. You feel me? Where it's like somebody can go from doing weird, funny, silly sketches to now be, he's like, mysterious film writer, director guy, you know?
It's who I am right now. But Hollywood don't like me.
If you keep saying that, they're not gonna like you.
I think they like me. I think they're fine with me.
Yeah.
I just I don't know, man. I just wanna do my own let me tell you this, dude. If you're in it to creating your own film and watching, even whether it's good or bad, is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
It just feels fucking good, you know what I mean? Like all the work and the effort that you put in to see it on the big screen, it's pretty fucking nuts, man. That feeling that I had will never go away. It's like my peak.
From Gook.
Yeah.
Well, let's guess what? You're going to go from award-winning, indie, metaphorical, beautifully done film to silly comedy with me.
I want to do a silly comedy so fucking bad just because I love silly comedies,
mm-hmm.
right?
And that's another thing I so look up to Jordan Peele for, because like he's put out a couple silly ass comedies. Like Keanu is like so dumb, so funny, and the fact that he can pivot and like get so much respect for Get Out and his other films, I'm like, ah, man, because I got weird shit I want to do, like really weird ideas, but I don't want to, but I can't do those until I fucking write my silly, silly comedy for you and me. And we're going to get it done. We're going to do this shit. And if it doesn't get picked up, I'm going to pay for this shit. We're going to do it. And super lit. Veda's going to start preschool in August. So we can film the movie when she's in school from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m.
This is only going to be a daytime film. The night doesn't exist in this film at all.
And when she goes to sleep, dog. So after 7:30 p.m., put the babies to sleep. We gonna work.
You're gonna have to be a deadbeat dad for about 2 months.
No.
You are going to have to be a deadbeat father.
No.
You are going to be away for her for at least a month.
No. I refuse.
You cannot do it.
No.
You cannot
do it. We are only filming when she's in school and when she's asleep. That's it.
We are never gonna get this film done. We are never going to get this film done.
She's too fun. She's too fun right now.
Let me tell you something, dude. If you were doing this on a low budget and you have that type of time constraint, you're never going to get this film done.
No. We're doing it and that's it. Thank y'all for watching another episode of Dudes Behind the Foods. Make sure you like,
I don't believe
comment.
In you.
Oh, I almost forgot. Holy shit.
Next episode. This episode too. Fuck yeah.
No, because we gotta make sure these sell or else they don't get made.
All right.
We have exclusive Lil Tim and Lil David plushy little cuddly little fucking toys.
When you guys receive these toys, I want you to do our voices on it as well, right? And I just want you to be like, I'm famous too. And who knows, we might have other iterations of this. You know, it could be the I Am Famous 2 one. It could be the I'm so sorry one. You got the I'm off cheese one. And then the Thai chili pepper one would be the next one.
These drop April 1st. Makeshift. I'll put a link in the description. And here's what's funny. Look. I made sure, I was like, here guys, here's my notes. Can you make sure the David doll is a little bigger than the Tim doll?
I noticed that.
Just for accuracy.
And it's very unnecessary. And if it was accurate, my doll would also be taller, but we're the same height.
No,
bullshit.
No, no. No, you are a little bit taller, see?
Okay, a centimeter.
And look, David has a secret society shirt on. I have a goodie beanie on. And
beautiful.
Look, and and he comes with, David's comes with a little ice cream that you can take off.
That's fucking awesome.
And a little drink, okay? And then mine's comes with a little drink and a little Thai chili pepper.
That's fucking awesome.
And the Velcros are opposite, so we can hold hands.
Wow.
We can hold hands.
Wow, you guys have to cop these.
Yeah, and look at all that customization, guys. Look, admittedly, I thought the price that they told me that we had to sell them at was a little steep. It's their $28.99 each. Bet old peep game. Then I Googled how much like a fucking Mickey is. And it's the same shit. They're like $30.
And they're
right?
Shittier.
And y'all gotta remember, these are like fucking, these are custom shits. You know what I'm saying? You can't just go to the store to get this. This is custom shit. It's all like, you know, cut and sewn very specifically. It's us exclusive shit. It's only gonna be on sale for 3 weeks, okay? So, Lil Tim, Lil David, check it out.
Cop it.
Thank you for watching. Bye. Yo, it's the dudes behind the food. Dudes.